Hey tech enthusiast, welcome back to the channel. Today we are diving into a super exciting and practical topic, and that is connecting multiple databases to your web API. Imagine having the flexibility to use both SQLite and an SQL Server in your application. Sounds amazing, right? Whether you're looking to leverage SQLite for lightweight or local storage, or SQL Server for robust enterprise level data management, we've got to cover it. In this video, I'll walk you through the step-by-step process of integrating both databases in your .NET Web API. So let's get started. I have my project created, and that is a Web API project created. So make sure you also create your own project. Now, when you are done, the first thing that we need to do here is to install our packages. Now, what packages do we need? We need an EF core package. We need the SQL Server, that's the database. We need an SQLite since we're going to integrate these two databases. But if you want to integrate another one, such as a MongoDB, Postgres SQL, I've made a video on how to connect both to your project. So you can now put them in the video description. But for now, we are handling two databases here. It could be two or more. Let's make it two for now, okay? So we want to connect SQL Server and SQLite. So you want to install these packages. Aside from that, we need an EFCore.tools so we can integrate database migration in application. These are the four packages that we need. So let's install them. So as usual, I have them already installed. So I'll just go to this page, project, and I'll unload it. So after unloading this project here, I am going to add this package references here. Now, I told you that we need four packages. So that's the EF core, that's the first one. We need SQLite, SQL Server, and now two. So make sure you have these packages installed correctly. Now, once I'm done, I can just reload this. Reload project with dependencies. Yes, and now I have the packages included in this project because I've installed them on a different project. So I have these packages on my computer already. That's the reason why I am reloading them in here. Okay, but if you are not, you can just right click on dependencies, you go to manage NuGet packages, and in there you can type in the names in here, and I'll try to install them from the browse tab. You type in the names and I install them here. Okay, so now that this has been installed, now what we're going to do next here is we can build that project to see if all these packages are well installed or restored in the application. So while this is done building, the next thing that we're going to do here is to we're going to create models. So let's assume you want to handle authentication or user logins in the SQLite. And now from our product, we want to keep them in the SQL Server. So SQLite here is going to handle our authentication, and now the product is going to be in the SQL Server. We do this to have separation of concerns. We want to split the data based on the databases. Okay, so we want to do that. So we need to create our two models. Now the first model here is going to be our user, and we're going to have our product as well. So let's create folder in our project, then we can give it a name as models. Now in this models, let's first have product, or maybe we can have user model. So this is going to be a class, isn't it? So create your class, and I'll name it as user, or any name at all that you want to create, any model at all that you want to create, you can do that. But for the purpose of this video, we are creating a user model. So user model is going to have only three properties in here. That is username, email, and password. Password is not part. We have an ID, we have name and email. You can decide to add password. Well, this is just a template showing you how to do it. So you can customize this to suit how you want it to be done. Okay, so now that we're having this, let's also create another one because we need two models now for each database. Now let's create another one in here. And this is going to be product. You want to handle product model. Now with this product model, we want to have a look at the properties. That's an ID, name, and a price. That is only what we want. Okay. Now we need to include this because this is coming from data annotations. So we need to make sure it is there. Okay. So now that we have this, we need to create our DB contest. So we can create another folder and I'll name it as contest. So let's see. This is our contest. Now, in our contest, we can create two contest classes. Now, the first one, let's say this is product DB contest. It's a class. Then we can also have another one in here, and that's going to be public. And this user DB contest. Okay, so now that we have this contest class created, what we're going to do here is we're going to inherit this from the DB contest. So first of all, from a product, we need to create a constructor for this. This, we must inherit this from DB contest. So inherit this DB contest here, and now we have that. And you can see we have a DB set created. So this is going to be a table name. It's going to use these properties here as columns in this table. Now you need to do the same thing to the DB user DB contest. So it's also here from DB contest, and in that we need to also create the same constructor. And now let's create a DB set for the user. So we also have the same thing in here. Now we don't want to put them in the same namespace. So in the same, so let's move to a separate file. Click on this. And now move to move type to DB contest. Yeah, so we have this DB, we have product DB contest. Then we have user DB contest. Now that we are done with this, all that we need to do here again is to register this contest file in the program.cs file. By wait, are you waiting? Before you do this, we must create our connection string. Okay, so click on the apsettings.json, and now in that we need to specify our connection strings in there. We need a connection string for the SQLite and also for the database SQL server. So I have them created already, so I'll just have to grab them like this. And now we have them. So that's our connection string in here. And now we have an SQL Server connection and an SQLite connection. So that's the connection. And now here you can use your server. That's an MSSQL/DB. Or you can use dot or local, referring to your local database. This is your product name or the table name. So maybe let me make it as YouTube. And also let me do same here. So YouTube users DB. And now from the SQL Server trusted connection to true, and our trust server certificate also true. So when you are done, that is all thing that you need to do. You save this. Now let's go to the program.cs file. Now it is the time for us to work on that. So click on that. And now once it's open, we need to register connection for both databases. Okay. So let's see how we can do that. So with just four lines of code, we can actually register them here. So you can see we are having builder.services.addbcontest. We specified the two contests that we created. This is a user DB contest and that's a product DB contest. In that, we specify the connection class or the section name in here, SQLite connection and our SQL Server connection. So that is a way. So in case you have multiple connections here, multiple databases that you want to connect all of them. Maybe you have MongoDB, you can add MongoDB. If you have PostgreSQL, you can add that as well. Okay, then keep adding. Okay, so now that we are done with this, the next thing I'm going to do here is we're going to perform database migration. Now, I know that when you use the normal create or add migration, maybe initial or first or any other name at all, since we have two contest class created in here, the EF could be confused. It will not know which one to choose. So in that, you must be explicitly defined the or make this contest available. So we're going to perform migration to each contest. Click on Package Manager Console. And now maybe we need to build our project first so we can faster the process of migration. So now that we wait, yes, I see that. We go to our Package Manager Console, then add migration. I can give it as this is first, or let me say product DB contest. Okay, so product DB, that's the name I'm giving to it. And now select contest. The contest here, it is a product DB contest. Okay, so this is what we need to do. Now let's run this, and it's going to build this because we've built it already. Now it's going to create the file for us. After that, we're also going to create the same for, yes, now we have it. So we have it in here. Now let's update that. So update database, and also specify the contest as well. And that is a product DB contest. So we are handling the contest for the product. When we are done, we do same to the other one. Okay, so let's see. So it's updating it. Great. Now let's do same. So add migration. And this is going to be, let's say, user DB. That's the name. And aside from that, I'm giving it the contest as user DB contest. After that, you're also going to update it. So done. Now update database, and now specify the same contest. So user DB contest. So when this is done, it tells you that we now have a database in place. And the next thing that we're going to do here is, you know, we are having two databases and we are having two contest classes. Now, are we going to inject them in our controller or in our services? Yes, we can actually do that. But for organization's sake, I have created a simple class where we have to register that, create either a scope or singleton or transient. Then we can create an instance of this DB contest that we've created in it. So all that you need to do here is to inject the composite class, which contains all the DB sets, and now we can have a look at the DBs, all the DBs in a database. Okay, so it looks like a unit of work. Okay, having all the repository in one class so we can be using it. Well, let's have a look. Now in here we're going to create a class, and in the same contest, let's create a class, and I'm going to name it as composite DB contest. The reason why I'm doing that is it contains multiple contests. So I'm going to say composite DB contest. You see? So now this composite DB contest class that I have, all that I need to do here is quite simple. I need to create a constructor in here. Now within this constructor, you see I'm initializing this. So maybe we can use a primary constructor method here, control period. So maybe here, control period, we can use a primary constructor introduced in the C# version 12. Yes, now we have it in here. You can decide to even remove this or maintain it as it is. Well, it's going to work. Okay, so now that we have this, all the next thing that we need to do here is register this DB contest. You can either create a scope, transient, or singleton. So let's go to the same program.cs file. And now here, let's have a beta.services. So the services.add, I like to use scope, then specify the composite, and now close it up, terminate it. So now that we have this, we don't need to be injecting the app DB contest or the product DB contest or user DB contest. All that you need to do here is inject the composite DB contest, which combines the two contexts, and you can now go ahead and use it. Now in here we need to create our controller, right? So here I have a controller here created already, so I'm not going to create that. Let me just paste this controller here so that we have a look what it entails. So let me remove this controller default, and I'm going to paste this controller here, the same weather forecast. And now this weather forecast, I have this, let me just remove, make sure it is the project name. Okay, composite DB contest is coming from contest folder, so make sure you also put the namespace. Now since we are not into this, we can remove this. And now we are having just get and now set, so part of the CRUD. Okay, so when you have a look here, let me just include the models. You could say we just inject the composite DB context, and now that's the product get. So from get, you see we have composite dot, then we can have access to this product context. And then through this product context, we have a DB set known as product. We can get it and we can start manipulating it. The same thing applies to the get. You can see you have a user DB context, and now we can get the table and now start manipulating. That is, so we have two get and now two post. So we're making an insert and we're making a retrieval. So you can see from here we are adding. After that, we can now save, return created, and we do the same thing to the user DB context as well. Okay, so now that this is working, let's see. So we have the name as data controller. Maybe yes. I think a weather forecast doesn't make sense. So let's change this to the name in here. Now that we have this created beautifully, we are done. That is all. Now let's see, for you to check the DB, that is the SQLite, you see we have an SQLite added here, right? And our database also configured for an SQL server. Now all that you need to do here is to run this and I'll check it out. Alright, so you see that it is ready in here. As you can see, we have a get and get for both databases, and we have add and add for both databases as well. We have two get, two post, right? Now let's see. So here we are adding products, and we can add a default product in here. So let me add at least price in here. Now let's see if this is going to be added to the database or it won't. Then we see the weirdness thing to do. Yeah, it is. So you see we have 204. Now let's add the same thing to the user. Now I have tried this out, so that's the email. So let me make it at mail.com, and now let's execute this. 204, so created. Now let's go to the gets and now check it out. So from product, try this out. You see we have it. Now let's go to user, try this also out. We also have it. If you want to actually verify, you see from the SQL Server Object Explorer, you can have it in here as a product. So this is a database YouTube product. This is a database, and this is a database, and that is the table. So if I refresh this, you see we have the content or the record in here, and that's what we have. Now I have for the SQLite too, I have DB browser for SQLite application installed. And I need that I can just access, open my database. So if I open it, that is a user. I have only one table, that's a user. And it's coming from the YouTube user db.db, which is coming from the project that we created. If I refresh this, I also have the same data, the same record from the user that we added in here. Yeah, so that's a way to simply connect database to two or multiple databases. Yeah, to do a short recap, in this tutorial, we've explored the dynamic duo for SQLite and SQL Server in a single web API project. Now, in that, we set up the databases. We've seen how to configure both SQL Server and SQLite in our development environment. That's an AppDB context, our apsettings.json, creating connection, registering connection, and a whole lot. We've seen how to configure them in the program as well. How to perform migration and how to perform just CRUD, that is a get and now add or create verbs or method in it. And we've seen that yes, it is working. So thank you for sticking around with him throughout this journey for connecting multiple databases to our web API. I hope you found this tutorial insightful and practical for your development needs. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe for more tech tutorials and tips. If you have any question or need further clarification, drop them in the comment below. I would love to help you out. Happy coding, and I'll see you in the next video.